lovelies, it's Nisha. So today we are going to talk about Tati Beauty Blendiful. And, well, I have a lot to say about it. This is not my first impressions. I've used this sponge, including today, well, sponge, Blendiful. I've used it 4 times now. Let me just quickly tell you about my shopping experience. So I ordered it on the 16th of January. The same day I got a confirmation email that my order has been shipped. I got a tracking number. Now, how much did I pay? So the Blendiful, you get obviously two. You get the big Blendiful and the baby one, heart-shaped. The price for them both is $18. But the shipping was $9.95 and the tax was $5.59. So another 15, almost the same price as the Blendiful, just for tax and shipping. So altogether, this cost me $33.54, which in today's exchange is £25.62. What do I think about the price? The beauty blender is £17, so £8 less than this. But I understand this is new, revolutionary, and you get two. So I'm not too mad about the price for what it is. But what I'm mad about is that mine is falling apart. So after the first wash, I got a tiny tear in here. It's not a tear, it's just that the stitching's gone. After the second wash, I got another one. After the third wash, I got these two. So it's basically falling apart. I am going to email them and send them the picture because, you know, I've paid almost twice as much as it costs, and soon it will be just flapping all over the place. Also, don't think that this is gonna look like new when you've washed it. And it takes a bit of washing to get it clean, but that's fine, you know, it's just staining. But if you see people washing it and it looks beautiful as new, no, it doesn't, unless I think you put it in a washing machine. And I haven't done that yet, and I'm scared to do it because I think it will definitely fall apart. But I think if you put it in a washing machine, which it says you can, then that will come up beautifully. I also would like to know, when you put it in a washing machine, should you be using fabric softener with it or not? It just does not say. So I've washed it with different soaps, I've washed it with brush cleaners, and, you know, I'm not mad at it because this is just staining from makeup. I know the actual Blendiful is clean, and I wash it straight away after each use, just leave it to dry, and it dries really quickly. So this is quite good. I don't mind doing that. Also, you can use this side as well. I suppose you could flip this over. Yeah, you can just flip that over and use this side as well. So, okay, now why did I order it? When it first came out and Tati talked about it, I was like, I wasn't excited at all. I didn't think I was gonna like it. Just another pain in the butt to wash. And to be honest, I didn't know how doing makeup with essentially what looks like microfiber cloth would work. But, you know, I was very, very curious. I wanted to see if this is going to be something that is going to change my makeup game. So I will tell you now how I use it. I will show you clips of me using it and what I think about it. First of all, I see people using it with a lot of cream stuff, because you can use it for foundation, concealer, liquid bronzer, powder bronzer, powders and creams and everything you like. I haven't used it with any primer because I don't really use primers, but I tell you my experience with applying foundation with it. I feel you have to take into consideration my age, you know, my skin. I've got more mature skin. I'm sure you've seen a lot of reviews of this by very young women here on YouTube, and you know, to be honest, they could put makeup on with a brick and you will look beautiful. But for us, you know, more mature women over 40 and up, it is a bit more challenging. So I've tried it with three different foundations and I've come to conclusion that for me, you know, I've got mature skin, it's quite dry. Obviously, I've got a lot of dryness and fine lines under my eyes. The thinner the foundation, the better this works. Why? Because you use it dry. So you don't have it like with Beauty Blender. Beauty Blender will dilute the product a bit, soak up a bit of product so you can sheer it out. With this, nothing soaks in this. So every scrap of makeup that is on Blendiful will be deposited on your face and you will stay there. So I found with like thicker foundations, you also need to use less because unlike beauty sponge, that doesn't soak up any product. So it just presses it in. And when I used it with a thicker foundation, I think it was with the Anastasia foundation. It is not very thick, but it is thicker than my others. I felt quite dry and a bit cakey. It was very nice, you know, finish, but it was almost too much of it. And it does, the application leaves you with the drier feeling than as if you did it with Beauty Blender, because like I said, Beauty Blender you use damp, so it soaks up a bit of product, I would say almost diluted, and leaves a bit of moisture on your skin, whereas this doesn't. So today I used it with one of my all-time favorite foundation, which is the Shiseido Synchro-skin. This is the original one. This is not the self-refreshing. This is not the glowy one. This is the original Synchro-skin foundation. I raved about it about 2 years ago. I've repurchased it again because I love it. With this foundation, this works beautiful. So as you can see, I use it in a sort of swiping and patting motion. So you're almost working the foundation in. And that seemed to work really well. It sort of makes your foundation to become one with your skin. And I love the finish. It looked really nice. I didn't feel I had to build up this foundation because, like I said, nothing is being soaked up. It's all staying on my face. Now with the concealer, yes, it blends concealer, but I think for mature eyes, this is not the best tool to apply concealer with. This is just my opinion. I feel, and from a mature skin point of view, I have fine lines, and like I said, you need to use much less concealer, and I did. but because of the little lines, it does not really, it does blend it in, but it's not as good as if I did it with just the warmth of my finger or with Beauty Blender that will sheer it out. But nevertheless, it still blends it. I just don't think for mature wrinkly under eye, this is the best. Now, I've tried it with liquid bronzer, you know, cream bronzer, and I've tried it with cream blush and cream highlighter. And to be honest, I found it quite difficult, especially doing this side. So you would bend this, use the edge, and I didn't have the same control as I would have with the Beauty Blender or with the brush, like a stippling brush. So I prefer using liquid bronzers, contours with a stippling brush or a Beauty Blender. But this is very nice for doing your liquid bronzer into your hairline. It definitely blends that nicely into your hairline. So, you know, I've got mixed feelings about that. With the liquid blush, I have a liquid blush that is very liquid, and I found that, again, I didn't have much control. Maybe because I'm not experienced with cream or liquid blushes. I don't use them that often. So again, I prefer just to pat that with my fingers. The liquid highlighter was absolutely fine using it with that. If you use the small corner and just use it like this. So I'm not showing you how I do the liquid stuff because I've used just powders. So the next thing was I applied bronzer, sort of try to contour, and again it was a bit difficult. What I like about it is that you really patting that bronzer in, so again it becomes one with your skin. But when it comes to control, maybe just I need more practice and experience. This is very new to me. I've never applied makeup with anything like that. So as you can see, I went over with the bronzer brush. I just found it much easier. So I did my brows and then I came back and did the powder. So I took like the smallest corner, folded it, dipped it in powder and set under my eyes. And this is almost like baking because again, you don't have that much control of how much powder you put in on your face, because once you dip this in powder, you can't really get that much excess off. It's not as much as baking, but you still could see the powder. And again, at my age, I'm trying to use less and less powder under my eyes. So even though on a camera it looks beautiful, and even in real life, it looks quite powdery. Nevertheless, I think if I applied the same amount of powder with a brush, it would look worse than it looks with Blendiful. That, like I said, really presses the product in. And for the powder everywhere else, I really loved using the little hard Blendiful, the baby Blendiful. And this is such a good, honestly, I really love this to press the powder in. Again, the powder presses in beautifully, and it really, really sets your makeup. And also you can use it throughout the day to just touch up. If you get a bit oily, press it in and you should be fixed. Now with the powder blush, I found it quite easy. With the powder, I had a bit more control than with the cream blush. But again, I probably would rather do it with a brush. Highlighter was absolutely fine doing it with the Blendiful. And then I sprayed my whole face with the setting spray and I was done. So you can see close up how this all looks. I must say the makeup looks really, really nice. Okay, so now my final thoughts. The price, I think it's okay. You know, if you're ordering something from US, you know that you have to pay the taxes and all that. And I think this is something very new to the market. So, and you get two. So I don't think the price is that bad. But what's bad is that these things fall apart almost after first wash. And that's not good at all. You know, it should be made really, really well, because if they expect you to wash it every day, it should be able to withstand that. So this must be some sort of designing fault, or maybe it's just me. I don't know if other people have experienced that. So this is not good. Now, will this replace my brushes, my makeup sponges? Absolutely not. I do like it for foundation, but only very thin one, like I said. And I probably will use it for that. And I also love this for pressing in powder. And I think I might take it when I'm traveling, because that will substitute like 5 or 6 face brushes. So I might take that traveling. So I think it's a very good travel tool. So I think it will take us a while to get used to it. This is so different. You remember when Beauty Blender first came out and people were like, what? But sponges have been used in makeup for a long time. Different type of sponges, but they have been used in makeup. I know some people say, oh, I can use powder puff, you know, like the Laura Mercier powder puff to do all this. You can't. It is slightly different texture, fabric. I would say the hairs are a bit longer than on a powder puff, so it is different. And also I feel that when you do your whole makeup with this and press the powder in, I feel like your makeup looks good for longer, as opposed to when I've done it with other tools. So definitely this pressing makeup into your skin helps a lot. So why would I buy it again? Not right now. I am going to keep using it, and you never know. Like I said, this is very new, very different and alien way for me to apply makeup with. And maybe the longer I do it, I get better at it. I find different techniques that work for me, and I might love it. So I'm not saying that this is a must-have, but I'm not saying that this is a rubbish product. This is a very good product. I commend Tati for, you know, being brave to bring something so different to the market. So yes, time will tell. You know, I didn't think that doing just like a first impression would give me enough information to review this for you. Because, you know, if you are very young, like I said, you can put your makeup on with a brick and you will look nice. Also with this, I feel like you need to experience it a bit and have few goes to really, really know if you like it or not. So I like it, but I don't think this will replace my other tools. But then you don't know. In the future, it might. So I just hope they saw this problem out. I am going to email them and hopefully they will send me a new one, and we will see. Okay, my lovelies, please let me know in the comments if you've bought it, if you like it or don't like it, how you use it, and if you have problems with splitting like I have. But for now, that's all. I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching and stay fabulous. Bye. So after that, I applied a powder black. After that, I applied a powder powder blah blah blah. And after that, I applied powder blush.